Throughout history, we have designed and developed technologies to further our exploration capabilities, both within our home planets and across the vast expanse of space. In this season of An Interloper's Guide, we will explore technology inspired by the natural world and meet some of the creatures responsible for our own technological advancements. Subscribe so you don't miss this season of An Interloper's Guide to Biomimicry. Our journey starts as most life does, beneath the waves. This is Dumar, an ice-bound planet found within the Canthian region of galactic hub space. The planet's frostbitten landscape offers many challenges for survival, all of which its native animals have, over millennia, evolved to overcome. During Dumar Tau's 40-month year, some regions experience a prolonged period of darkness that can last up to 4 months. Beneath the waves, this makes already poor visibility increasingly difficult, especially for those residing at deeper depths. The planet's oldest aquatic species, Weedfrahii, is so well adapted to deep underwater environments that its design has remained untouched by evolution for millions of years. The secret to their success lies in their most prominent feature, their eye. Weedfrahii's vision is unparalleled in the animal kingdom, and the species can both see and navigate in environments completely void of light. Surrounding their pupil, small jelly-filled organs house specialized sensory receptors, capable of detecting movement within the water's electrical and magnetic fields. These electroreceptors not only help to map out the surrounding terrain, they also enable Weedfrahii to sense minute movements produced by their plankton prey, helping to locate them in the vast darkness of the ocean. Their barbed tentacles capture their minute prey and aid the creature's movement through the ocean currents. Weedfrahii's advanced electroreception became the inspiration behind the technology used in underwater Exo-Craft, allowing us the ability to see in our deepest, darkest waters. The Nautilon, the galaxy's most advanced underwater Exo-Craft. The outside of its canopy is covered in small transparent sacs of conductive jelly, arranged in similar design to that of the Weedfrahii's eye. At the center of these sacs, synthesized electroreceptors detect minute electrostatic and magnetic fields that are emitted by everything, living or otherwise. These signals are sent almost instantaneously throughout the ship's sensor array processor, where the data is collated to create an incredibly accurate image of the surrounding environment without the need for light. This nature-inspired technology has allowed us not only to see in our deepest oceans, but to selectively locate precious underwater minerals within a vast scanning radius. Lack of light is not the only challenge underwater environments present. The deeper we go underwater, the more pressure our body is exposed to. This is Erelis, the only glacial planet of five found within the Ugkarma-Ked system. It boasts the deepest seas so far discovered in the arm of Katteus region of hub space, and is a hotspot for both deep sea divers and Nautilon explorers. As we explore deeper environments, the pressure exerted on our bodies or the vessel we are traveling in increases by around 1 atmosphere for every 10 meters traveled. This can crush both our lungs and any submersible vessels, making deep diving a near impossible task. To cope with this increased pressure and to further our underwater exploration, we once again look to nature for the solution. In the deepest of Erelis' waters, only one creature has adapted to survive in its high-pressure environment. The Postpausosa. Living at depths of up to 5,000 meters below sea level, the species can endure 500 times that of the surface atmospheric pressure. That's approximately 5,000 tons. Like us, its lungs and nervous system would be crushed under such forces. So how does the Postpausosa survive? Encompassing the creature's hollow body is a membrane filled with a specialized liquid with unique properties. When exposed to intense pressure, it is capable of exerting the exact same pressure back, meaning this liquid membrane does not buckle or warp under the weight. This enables the Postpausosa to maintain an interior pressure of 1 atmosphere, even at deep depths, keeping its vital organs safe from collapse. In the early days of Exo-Suit crafting, technicians extracted liquid directly from the Postpausosa themselves, in the hope it would afford interlopers the same pressure resistance when incorporated. The results were better than anticipated, leading to one of the biggest revolutions in Exo-Suit history. Interlopers could now explore deep underwater environments without succumbing to the intense pressure, though it came at an extremely high cost. The increased demand for this liquid led to a near-extinction event for the Postpausosa, and today they have all but disappeared from many of their native habitats. In fact, 99% of the galaxy's remaining wild Postpausosa live in Erelis' waters, and it is here that conservationists and technicians have stepped in to address the problem. Only within the last few decades has a synthetic version of this pressure-exerting liquid been successfully replicated, becoming industry standard in all exosuits manufactured today. The Postpausosa population is slowly recovering with the help from conservationists, and plans to reintroduce them back to their native environments is currently underway, though it could be generations before the damage is undone. Interlopers can help with these conservation efforts by visiting Erelis at the address on screen to help transport Postpausosa eggs to new suitable environments. By mimicking the designs of nature, we have made underwater environments more accessible, overcoming many of the challenges faced when exploring these territories. We can now dive deeper than ever before, affording us access to the bounty of precious minerals and materials found only beneath the waves. Nature's designs have been critical in advancing both our Exo-Suit and Nautilon technologies, though underwater environments are not all she has helped us to conquer. Subscribe to catch the next episode as we delve into the explosive world of volcanic environments and introduce some of the creatures that have inspired the protective technology in use today. Thank you for watching and for all the support throughout Season 1 and 2. We hope you have enjoyed this episode, and as always, have fun, stay safe, and be curious.